You know, out here, outdoor entertainment options are limited. Right? I mean, the weather, it's a beautiful place when the weather's nice, but the weather's not nice that long. I know, I've seen you. My brother lives out here. You get excited, and there's a nice day, and you run to your calendars, and you go, ooh, it's summer. Summer fell on a Tuesday this year. And everyone runs into the valley and just looks for something to do. I have to do something. I'm outside. And there is an enterprising man with a house by the river. It's the Gaspereau River. He has a house, and the Gaspereau River flows down from his house, and he has figured out, if I inflate stuff, people will pay me to rent that inflatable stuff and float down the river. Not a lot of overhead, right? It's not a sanctioned ride. It's not like rides at water parks where you're something you're supposed to be sitting in with a handle and it's safe and there's a waiver to sign. Not this guy. Just whatever's nearby that he can put air in, he will rent you for $3. Now, I got lucky because I got a tire that looked like it had been in a tractor. It fit me pretty well. My brother was with me. He got a bike tire that looked like it was in a 10-speed that morning. He didn't get a good tube. And they don't give you the warnings that they do at water parks. This is what he said. Oh, water's low, rocks are high. Good luck. Okay. All right. That seems fair. Okay. So we get into the river, and we're not alone. There are many, many, many people who have lined up for this opportunity because it's summer, it's Tuesday. Let's get into that river, for God's sakes. I'm with my wife, my brother is with his wife, and we get in, and they're in front of us a little bit, and almost immediately, my brother flips out of his tube. Ass over tea kettle, just gone. Poof. My immediate response as a concerned younger sibling is, because this is a brother that beat me up a lot when we were younger. And I am concerned, but I'm also, just for that brief amount of time, I'm glad he's gone. Not really. I'm assuming he's going to resurface any moment. So my wife and I carry on around a bend in the river, and we're just having a great time. We're going to let them catch up to us once Ross gets back on his tube. So we're holding on to a branch, watching many people go by on many different inflatable things, because some of you are too cheap to rent the tubes, so you've just figured something else out is you can jump into the river whenever you want on whatever you found at your house. So a grown man comes by us, and I couldn't make this up. A grown man comes by us hammered, very, very drunk, on an inflatable children's chair. I don't know how he fit in it. He's got one cheek in and another on the arm. He's wedged a beer into the child's cup holder. And this is what he is saying. Somebody call 911. There's a woman back there whose husband fell out and she's just beside an empty tube going apeshit crazy. And then he continues floating down the river. And I look at my wife and I go, well, I'd hate to be that woman. That's got to be, you're just out for a nice day, that poor family. I wonder who that woman is. And then I find out, it's my sister-in-law. She comes by, empty tube beside her. My brother never resurfaced. She is indeed going apeshit crazy. And apeshit crazy people will yell out the weirdest recommendations in the world in an effort to try to solve the situation. She turns to my wife, who happens to be a strong swimmer. She goes, Nancy, you swim up and see if he's up there. Now, hold on. This was no time to explain physics, but there's no way that he fell out and floated up the hill. It's just not possible. And secondly, why does my wife have to swim against the current, knocking other people off their children's inflatable chairs? She goes, I'm going to go to the bottom, see if he made it down there. Steve, you go in that field over there, see if he's there. Okay, Aaron, I will. I mean, I don't think that rocks are trampolines, so I don't think he fell down and then bounced 100 meters through the sky and landed in a field, but I'll try. Sure, I'll try. So I get out, and I'm trudging through a field in flip-flops with a tube on my shoulder. And I think, at this point, I think my brother might be dead. I'm not sure what's happening. It's not a good time in my life. I'm trudging through a field, dejected. And I look over and see a group of cows. Because I'm in a cow's field. It's not their fault. I'm in their territory. Now, I don't know how many, there was between 4 and 16. It doesn't matter. If you've ever been in a field with cows and they outnumber you, it doesn't matter. How many there are, there's more than you. And I'm walking dejectedly, and I'm thinking, this is horrible. This is a terrible day. This was just supposed to be a fun day of rafting. And that son of a bitch waters low, rocks high. That clearly wasn't a good enough warning. And the cows look up at me. And put yourself in their position. This is the highlight of their life. I mean, when else is this going to happen for them? A man, a drenched, dejected man, has just wandered into their field, and you've immediately identified him as a steak eater. It's payback time, right? So the lead lady, she starts to run, hey? And her girls follow her. And you might not think cows can run. Hey, they can run. It's like when Trump speaks. You're not sure what's going to happen, but it's going to be interesting. So now they're coming towards me in a pack, and now I start to run. And now it's a race. And if you're wondering, hey, how fast can cows run? About the exact same speed as a man in flip-flops in a field. That's how fast. So now I'm running like this, and you're like, why do you still have the inner tube, Steve? Hey, $3, that's why. I'm not gonna lose my brother and a deposit on the same day. So now I'm running towards the field, and the cows are cutting the angle. They're not running straight. They're like a defensive unit. They are cutting the angle to the corner. They know where I have to go. Now I'm about 15 feet away. Only then do I realize, electric fence. I didn't see this going in. So now I have to make a decision. Do I just run into the electric fence and die because I'm completely soaked? Do I stop and try to fight the cows? What do I do now? And I make a decision in that moment, and this is how I know I'll be okay in a life-threatening emergency. I use what I got. I take the tube and I throw it over the fence. I myself jump over the fence and land on the tube. Perfectly, on my back, on the ground, just looking up at the stars, and I know I'm hurt because it's daytime. And the wind's kind of knocked out of me, and I walk back to the cows on the other side of the fence, and they're snorting, they're pretty angry. I do what you would do as a good sportsman in that situation. I walked by and got all the... Good game. Heck of a try. And then I turn farmer, who's been on porch the entire time. And this is what he does. Now, this is an absolutely true story. He looks to me. He's just witnessed all of this. Takes a swig of his beer and goes, good jump. That's what Nova Scotia is to me.